I'm all waffled out. Hey guys, it's Rose and welcome back to Cheap Lazy Vegan and another cook with me style video. Today guys, I wanna make waffle fries. Who does not love waffle fries? We all love waffle fries. We're gonna make waffle fries today, but in different forms, okay? So we are going to be using the air fryer. My absolute favorite appliance in the kitchen to make waffle fries. So first, I'm going to just make the waffle fries you buy in the freezer section of your grocery store, yes. And I also wanna try making waffle fries from scratch, from the actual potato. So we're gonna make them a couple different ways. I'm gonna test out the ways of making the waffle fries from scratch. I'm gonna compare prices, taste. Let's just see what happens. I'm very excited, okay? Okay, so first we're gonna make the easy peasy waffle fries that are already pre-made and you just have to basically heat it up in the oven. Or today we're gonna use the air fryer because the air fryer is superior. Oh. I'm using this one that I just got from Cavendish Farms. This one is vegan. I did check, yes guys, I checked. Yes, okay, just double checking again. So this one was $3.97 Canadian and this is 540 grams, okay? Like a pretty hefty bag, but it is almost $4 Canadian. Now, in contrast, you can buy a bag of potatoes, okay? This is a bag of potatoes, 2.27 kilograms of russet potatoes, and this was $5.97, so almost $6 for over 2 kilograms of potatoes. Potatoes are so cheap, okay? We're talking like this much potato right here, so much potato, you can make waffle fries for days, for weeks. Price versus convenience, it's always the battle, right guys? Okay, so now let's make the frozen waffle fries and see how they taste. We got the waffle fries. They look lovely. Mm-hmm. I'm just gonna shove a bunch of them here. I don't make too many because I'm making lots of fries today, so. All right, I think these are ready to go in the air fryer. You can also bake it, obviously, but today we're doing the air fryer. I'll have some links down below. Okay, guys, this is literally the best thing. Oh. So, let's do 400 degrees, and let's start with 10 minutes. Let's do it. All right, so while that is air frying, let's start making our own waffle fries from scratch. You can do whatever you want. You can just keep the skin on, but for some reason, I feel like I wanna peel the potato. I think I might actually leave a couple with the skin on just to test it out. What we need is a device, okay? I bought this contraption right here. This slicing device. You can make waffle fries, you can julienne, you know, it's like a vegetable slicer. You guys have seen these before. I'll leave the link for this in the description box. This one also comes with like safety gloves, which I will put on because, okay, I am a klutz. What I'm gonna do is, I think I'm just gonna, let's see if I have it. Oh, nope. Ah! Okay, okay. Okay, so what's, I'm getting ridgy fries? No, now I'm getting, it is proving to me a little bit more difficult than I thought. Before we do that, this is finished, I think. We might need to do it for a little bit longer. Let's see how it looks. Is it done? Ooh, I think it's done. Look at this, guys. There's the waffle fries. These are the frozen, ready-made waffle fries. They look pretty darn good, not gonna lie. Let's see, it feels very nice and crispy. Mmm. I mean, it's good. It tastes like, you know, a waffle fry. Mm. Mm-hmm. So easy. Now, if only I could figure out how to make this shape. Mm. Mm. All right, you guys, I'm not gonna lie. It has been forever. So it took me so long to try to figure out how to use this thing. I was like, oh my God, do I need to return it? So here is how to use it. So I have it set up properly. Okay, so it needs to be flat right here. And then this one needs to be waffly. Oh yeah, so you wanna do one swipe and then you wanna turn it like 90 degrees. Just kinda keep turning it. Look at that. And now you're getting these waffly shapes. So what I do is I have like a little bowl of like kinda cold water and I just put it in there and that way it kinda prevents it from becoming like gray. Like, you know when it like oxidizes and becomes gray? Just keep turning it as you do it and it's actually very easy.
I literally was like, oh my God, this is not working.
So if you like waffle fries, this is definitely worth getting. So I have here the, you know, the waffly shaped potatoes in some water. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna experiment. So I'm gonna take half of this and I'm just going to, so I'm gonna use about half of what we just made. I'm just gonna place it on paper towel just to roughly dry it. I don't know if I need to. Then I'm just going to immediately basically put it in the air fryer, essentially. But I'm gonna just season it a little bit first. And the other half, I'm gonna boil it a little bit first. And then I'm gonna air fry it and see if it makes a difference, if it's worth the boiling. I'm just experimenting here, okay? All right, so we got the potatoes. These are just the raw potato. I'm gonna add a bit of oil. Just gonna make sure it's nice and coated. And then I'm also going to add, I'm just gonna keep the seasoning really simple, but you can obviously feel free to do whatever you want. Just a bit of salt. Again, just kinda, and I'm just gonna do some garlic powder, okay? Feel free to add other seasonings as well. All right, now we're just gonna place them on the air fryer tray. You can, you know, have them overlapping a bit, but like don't try to like have it too overlappy, but they can overlap a little bit. It's fine. Here we are. Okay, so that is the first batch cooked with, we're air frying it. All right, you guys. The second batch, we are going to be boiling the potatoes for like 1 or 2 minutes first, and then we're gonna throw it in the air fryer. So let's see if that makes any difference. So we have the potatoes. I'm just gonna throw it in here. Whoop, whoop. All right, guys, it has been a minute. We've basically just blanched it. Now we're going to just strain it. All right, guys, so now I have these slightly boiled potatoes, and I'm gonna add some oil once again. I boiled them for about a minute or so. Maybe I should have done a little bit longer. I'm not really sure. We're gonna season it the same way. All right, and I think this batch is done. Ooh la la. Okay, everybody. So let's look at this batch. Ooh, so they kind of look a little bit chippy. Like, they're definitely a lot thinner than the frozen ones. It looks pretty nice and crispy, but yes, now we've kind of gotten, now we've got kind of like waffle chips in this scenario. It's not really waffle fries. Okay, I'm gonna try one. Let's try it. Mmm. Ooh. Oh my God. It's definitely a chip. Okay. Mmm. All right, guys. So we're gonna now throw in the next batch. This is the slightly boiled, slightly cooked batch. I feel like it's actually really good without cooking it. So currently my prediction is that it's not worth the extra step of boiling it. But who knows, right? Who knows? Now I'm gonna do a little bit less time because it's already slightly cooked. Okay. And this time I also wanna flip it, okay? All right, guys, so while we're waiting for this one, I figured out how we can get slightly thicker waffle fries. Guys, I am doing all of the experimentation. So you can adjust the level of this right here, so we're gonna adjust the thickness, but you don't wanna make it too thick, because then what happens, you're not gonna get the holes. You kinda have to find the kinda perfect thickness. So as you can see here, this one is a little bit thicker, but we don't have enough holes there. So what we wanna do is then we wanna make it slightly thinner, but not too much. Ooh, perfect! Okay, so it's still gonna be a little bit thinner than the store-bought kind, like the frozen ones, but, you know, it's still a bit thicker than chips, so we're gonna go for that. All right, you guys, so now I wanna do one more experiment while we wait for this to finish. I think it's almost done. So we're gonna do the same thing. We're gonna add some oil, okay? And of course, you can adjust the amount of oil you add. It's up to you, you guys. If you wanna keep it really low oil, you can do that as well. I'm gonna season it again the same way. Okay. Now, this experiment, I'm actually going to add some cornstarch. Okay, that's gonna be the experiment. I'm gonna see if it makes any sort of difference, okay? So for the frozen ones, I noticed that cornstarch was an ingredient, okay? And I thought, you know, it's probably not necessary because there's already so much starch, like potatoes are starch, right? So we're already starching it, but I feel like maybe it'll be more crispy. I don't know. So this batch is done. This is the boiled batch. Ooh. Okay, I'm just gonna immediately try the boiled batch. Okay. Interesting. This is the unboiled batch. Let me just try. Okay. I don't think there's enough of a difference for me to do that step. But it's quite good though. Let me see. It is definitely nice and soft. So it is a little bit softer, I think, on the inside and nice and crispy on the outside. Maybe it's in my head, but I do think the flavors soaked up a little bit better with the boiled batch. Anyway, let's try this third batch. All right, our final batch. Let's have a look. Ooh, oh, maybe I overcooked it a little bit. I'm not sure. Okay, interesting. Some of them are a little bit stuck together. Very interesting. So this is the one with cornstarch. All right, I'm just gonna give it a taste. Oof, let's grab one. So they do kind of stick together if you have cornstarch. So, I mean, you can always, cheers. Ooh. Mm-hmm. It does feel more crispy on the outside, but not enough that I would do it. You know what I mean? I feel like it's still good without the cornstarch. So yeah, let's have a look-sees at all of these different ones, okay? So this batch was the first batch where we cooked it, where we air fried it without boiling it, and we just did it with some oil, salt, and spices. This batch was the batch where we boiled it first, and then we tossed it in oil, salt, and spices. And this batch was the batch where we tossed it in cornstarch as well as oil, salt, and spices. Now, in my opinion, and this is just my opinion, I think that the first batch was good enough. As in, I feel like it doesn't make that big of a difference for me to do all of the other steps. I think it is just good as it is. Like, when I try the different kinds, now this one's cold, but yeah, so when I try the different kinds, in my opinion, the differences are very, very minuscule that I think it's not worth doing the extra steps. So the easiest batch, the laziest batch, wins. Yay! So you don't need to do all the other steps, in my opinion. I think it would make a difference if your waffle fries were thicker. So if you have thicker slices, then I think maybe boiling it would make a difference, because then that way the inside's gonna be a little bit more tender and then the outside's gonna be nice and crispy. So I think that's the only time it would make a difference, but if your waffle fries are super thin, like mine are, then I think it's not worth boiling it and doing all the extra stuff. All right, you guys, so that was my great waffle fry experiment. I'm all waffled out, okay? I don't know about you guys, but I'm waffled out. But that was a fantastic experiment. I learned a lot in the process. And I'm gonna have two blog posts linked down below. One is going to be how to air fry the frozen store-bought waffle fries, and one is going to be how to make your own waffle fries from scratch. I will have all of those in blog posts linked down below, so definitely check those out with all of like the temperatures and stuff like that. So I think overall my thoughts are that both are worth it. Making your own is definitely worth it. Also, using store-bought ones is also worth it. Just depends on your priorities, okay? So making your own is actually not that hard. Once you have the tools, so the tool is very easy to use. Again, I'll link that down below. I'll also link an air fryer down below as well if you guys are interested in getting an air fryer. Great Christmas gift, by the way. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed this experiment. Let me know if you guys want more kind of experiments like this, like store-bought versus homemade. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. Make sure you subscribe to this channel if you haven't already. Make sure you give this video a big thumbs up. And that's pretty much it, you guys. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye!